Develop a quality spiritual base. Point number two, discover your true purpose. Martin Luther said, if a man has not discovered one thing for which he can die, he is not fit to live. No wonder he led a 381-day boycott against racism. And he could say things like, I have a dream, I have a dream. I have a dream that on a day is coming on the red hills of Georgia. The sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will sit together and dine at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream, I have a dream, I have a dream that a day is coming in this state where my four little children will not be judged by the color of their skin but by the content of their character. That was a man of purpose. Look at a man like Steve Biko. He said, it is better to die for an idea that will live than to live for an idea that will die. You see, life has not started until purpose is discovered. A purposeless life is a profitless life. If you want to maximize destiny, discover your purpose. Don't invent your purpose. You have to discover it. It means the purpose is already there. Because God did not create you before he decided what to do with you. He decided what he wanted to do with you before he created you. So it is only wise that if you want to make most from this life, when you come, you begin to look out for the blueprint that he had for your life. Seek the manual for your life. And then begin to discover yourself again in God's ordained plan for you. Praise the Lord. So first, develop a quality spiritual base. Deep relationship with the Lord. Quality spiritual relationship with the Lord. Don't be detached from your maker. When you are detached from your maker, you are detached from your life source. And when you are detached from your life source, the life sap cannot flow through you. I pray that God will help you to develop a quality spiritual base. And after developing a quality spiritual base, a quality spiritual relationship with your maker, you have to discover your purpose. Discover your purpose. And when purpose is discovered, pursue it. Give it all it takes. Don't relent. Don't relent. Don't relent. Why am I on earth? Why did I come as a man and why didn't I come as a woman? Why was I born in Africa and I wasn't born in Europe? Why was I made? The Lord said concerning Jeremiah. He said, before you were in the womb, I knew you. Before you came out, I sanctified you. And I ordained you as a prophet unto the nations. So that was his purpose. It was defined for him. Jesus said, I must work the works of him that sent me whilst it is day. For the night cometh when no man can work. What is the works that God had for you before you also came on this earth? If you read the book of Hebrews, he said that, lo, in the volume of the books it is written, I come to do thy will, O God. God's will for you is your purpose for life, is your purpose for living. What is your purpose? What is your purpose? Why are you here? Why is it that you are still alive? Why are you not dead by now? There is a specific mandate upon your life. You need to discover it and give yourself to it and live it so that your life will not be a waste. You must maximize your life. You must maximize your life. You must maximize your life. After you discover your purpose, begin to run with it. Begin to run with it. Begin to run with the purpose. Your purpose becomes your vision for life. The Bible said that write the vision, make it plain. At the appointed time, it shall speak. Though it tarry, wait for it, for it shall surely come to pass, and it shall not tarry. Visions and purposes speak with time. Discover that true purpose and run with that purpose. Don't run as if you are so uncertain about what you are doing. 1 Corinthians 9:26, Apostle Paul says that, I therefore so run, not as one that beats the air. Not as one that beats the air. You are not beating the air. You are not beating the air. You are not beating the air. There is a specific race that is set before you. Therefore, he says, let us run with patience. The race, not a race. The race. Definite article. A specific race. That is your purpose. I know I was born to preach the gospel. So I am living within the perimeters of my purpose. It is wisdom not to dissipate my energy doing other things. Focus and pursue that purpose. Focus and pursue that purpose. Focus and pursue that purpose. Live a purposeful life. For a purposeless life is a profitless life. If nothing is working, it is because you are not making anything to work. And how do you make things work? You make things work by operating from your allotted space. That is your purpose. You cannot be everybody. Nobody can be you. Even twins do not have the same thumbprint. The day you were born, you came alone. Maybe you were even twins, and the day you die, you will go alone. Whilst you are here, do the reason why you are here. Jesus said to Judas, the purpose for which you came, hasten it. Praise the Lord. Don't live aimlessly. Don't live uselessly. You are not useless. God has an agenda for you. Make sure you live every second, every minute, and every day of your life, fulfilling that divine agenda that God has for you. Live a purposeful life.